Hi, we congratulate you for your rank, on the rank of 170 in Civil Services 2019. So, could you please share the top 5 reasons which you think are behind your success?
Okay, so first of all, thank you so much for the congratulations. Yes, so regarding the top 5 things, if I have to prioritize 5 important things, first one would be the aspect of curiosity. Because from the past 2 years, I believe curiosity is one thing that we have to develop in the civil services. The reason being, like, there will be some days where we will not be interested in some subjects. For example, there is a subject called geography, which I find a bit boring. If you see 11th class NCRT, there are chapters in 11th class NCRT completely based on theory concepts, and there will not be any diagrams. So I used to end up sleeping after reading 10 or 15 pages. So what I did instead of skipping that part is, I tried that knowledge, to gain that knowledge through an other ways. For example, there is a website called metoffice.gov.uk. And if you visit that website, and there is about us section, and there is learn page. So there, if you go and see the videos, they have explained every possible geographical concept through animated videos. So if you see that, hardly it will take for you around 3 to 4 hours. But your concepts will be crystal clear. So that is one of the way where you can actually fetch more marks in even the disinterested subject. So that way, if you try to cover everything which where you might find boring or hard, you'll be able to almost become master of all. Okay, so that's first thing.
Okay.
And second thing comes consistency. So that I believe is second most important thing. So it is not the hours count that matters. Because some might say 12 hours, some might say 18 hours. That doesn't matter at all. Because if you do 14 hours a day, and then immediately after a few days, if you switch to just 2 hours or 1 hour reading just a newspaper, or even sometimes there will be days where we'll skip the newspaper. That is not a good habit. So kindly try to maintain consistency, which is something possible. Like, for example, keep initially only 4 hours. Don't try to go for 8 hours on the first day itself. If you're starting, go just for newspapers for 2 hours. And after a few weeks, go for 4 hours. And then finally, 6 hours would be ideal thing. So if you maintain 6 hours consistently focusing on studying certain subjects, it will be, trust me, at the end, it will be much helpful. That is the second one. So coming to the third one, I believe our already topper, Anudeep Durishetty, had shared a quote regarding imperfection. So I strongly believe in that, because imperfection is the key to the perfection in this UPSC. So you don't need to be perfect to start your answers. Trust me, like, you better imperfect, because with that imperfection, you will commit as many mistakes as possible. And test series is the best way before the prelims or mains, your actual prelims and mains, to commit those mistakes and try to gain knowledge and come out of that mistakes, learn that lessons, and try to not do that mistakes again in the final UPSC. So don't try to read everything and then try to attempt the test series. Even if you know the basic concepts, with that imperfect knowledge also, you can start test series. At least, if not 100%, like 100 questions test series, if you can't start, at least start with the 10 questions or 20 questions per day. But start it, do it. So that is very important thing. Action is very important rather than planning in this. Planning is important, I agree. But action is even more important. So you have to start at some point instead of keeping on planning. So that is third thing. And then fourth thing.
Okay.
Yeah. So this is somewhere related to the imperfection part. So the practice. I can't stress the importance of practice like more than anything here. Because in UPSC, it is like ocean of syllabus. We all know that. So like we can't cover everything. So instead of going on a spree of reading everything, we have to limit our resources and practice. So like if you are going to do something, you ideally it should be 70% practice and 30% studying. Because we all, like, we are all graduates, or we have at least done degree in some humanities background. So we have basic knowledge, and UPSC is just testing the basic knowledge. So trust me on this, read the basic material like NCRT and then just start practicing. Just before the prelims, you have to start at least doing 40 to 50 full length tests. And I have done that. And apart from that, irrespective of which coaching test series you have done, you always have to do UPSC past 10 years papers just before the exam, because before the exam you need to get the hang of UPSC framework. Because if you write some test series, they will be focusing on some subjects or some angles. They might not be covering everything. So every test series will have only 15 or 20 questions which will be relevant to UPSC standard. So do those test series, but just 7 days or 10 days before UPSC exam, do only UPSC previous year questions. So at least 5-year papers if you do, you'll completely get into the hang of UPSC, like how it asks. Because there will be certain deliberate traps in UPSC way of asking. So you will know that only by solving it just before the exam. So solving it before the exam is even more important. So do that. So that is the fourth thing.
Okay.
And the fifth thing is, what personally I learned is, there is something which we can do before doing that mistakes in the final attempt. Like what I mean is, you have to learn from your mistakes. For example, the reason being why some people take it 4 attempts, some people take it 5, some people do it only in the first attempt is, they will commit the, they'll learn the mistakes either from others or they will commit themselves and then learn. So that is the difference, I believe. So we have to learn more from not just successful people, but actually who have not cleared this exam, because they will have more lessons to teach us. So that is most important. So learn from them. Try to not do that mistakes yourself. So that way you'll save a lot of time and even attempts. So that way you will be able to crack even in the first attempt itself. So in my case, it's, I have to advise myself, like Premsagar in 2018, I would advise him to do practice more, because that is something that I missed in the first attempt. That is why it costed me one attempt more. So that is lesson that you can learn and try not doing it by committing a mistake. So that is, those are the five things I trust. And one more additional like add-on for this.
Yes,
so I would say,
yes.
Yeah. So I would say, like, we all get demotivated at some point of time. Like, I know consistency, I said we have to keep focusing on. But if you get demotivated, you have to make your learning process interesting. For example, you don't need to always sit and read. Try to do it in a different format. For example, when I go for a jog, I listen to Indian Express 3 things. So do that kind of audio podcast. So that way you will develop an independent opinion. I'm not saying you to go for only 3 things or something. Do it All India Air Radio, because you have that programs also. So do that while doing some work. And similarly, when I go for lunch, I watch some Rajya Sabha TV debates. And similarly, I have a BBC News app. So there is a 1-minute video news section in that. So it hardly costs us 1 minute. While even drinking tea also, we can see international news. And if you do that, like checking the BBC News, like how you check your WhatsApp for every 4 hours or 5 hours, you don't even need to read the international section of Hindu paper, even the international affairs of GS2. So these are the small tricks which you have to make part of your life. Like UPSC should be your way of life, not as a target or something. So incorporate in your life. Don't target for 6 hours I will study. Because if you put it as part of your life, it will be like most enjoyable process. And trust me, you'll regret that after getting into rank. I'm missing that process, that enthusiasm from the process. So these are all the things that I would like to.
Thank you. Say. Thank you, Prem. Actually, you have given 6 excellent tips that you think have kept you among the top rankers. So I think this will be helpful not only for the people who are beginning with preparation, but also for those who failed previously and who won't write again this year. And we congratulate once again for your success. And thank you.
Okay. Thank you so much.